Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching the Today I Found Out YouTube channel. And in the video today, we're looking at how the calorie content of food is determined. First of all, let's make sure everybody here understands what a calorie is. A calorie is just a measurement of energy, the amount of energy needed to raise 1 gram of water 1 degree Celsius at standard atmospheric pressure. This makes sense when talking about calories in food. Food provides energy, and our bodies need this energy to function throughout the day. Second, it's also important to note that calories in food are actually measured in kilocalories, so 1,000 actual calories for every 1 calorie listed. Manufacturers used to measure calories using a bomb calorimeter. This process involved placing the food source in a sealed container filled with water. They would then burn the food with electrical energy. After the food completely burned up, they would measure the water temperature to see how many degrees it was raised, and thus how many calories had been used. In 1990, under the Nutrition Labeling and Education Act of 1990, the FDA began requiring food manufacturers to label the amounts of nutrients and calories contained in their products. This act resulted in moving away from the bomb calorimeter method for determining the number of calories in food. One reason for this was to make it easier and less expensive for manufacturers to meet the standard. Another was that the bomb calorimeter method measures all available calories in the product. Since most foods contain indigestible components like fiber that pass through our system and get excreted in the form of bum brownies, this would lead to a consistent overestimation of the ingested calories using the bomb calorimeter. Instead, they used an easier method known as the Atwater system. This approach adds up the calories available through the energy-containing nutrients in the food item, like protein, carbohydrates, fats, and alcohols. They use standard reference tables for common ingredients based on their energy densities. Things like 4 kilocalories for proteins, 4 for carbohydrates, 3 for organic acids, 9 for fats, and 7 for drinkable alcohols, ethanol. No wonder all that beer can give you a soft belly. It has over 1.5 the calories per mass as proteins and carbohydrates. It is well worth it, though. So for a specific example, let's say that tasty snack you have before you jump on the treadmill contains 5 grams of protein, 10 grams of carbohydrates, and 15 grams of fat. The label on that package would then read 225 calories, or technically 225,000 calories for those who can't stand oversimplification, which does result in misconceptions. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do give us a like below, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Over there on the right are a couple of other videos you'll probably enjoy if you enjoyed this one. I know if you're on a mobile device, you can't click those. You can't click the subscribe button below me, so there will be links in the description below. And thanks for watching.